741-4376.
Great, thank you. And like I said, you got my vote. And best of luck.
Thanks for calling in, Julie. We appreciate it. Thanks for listening. You're listening to the Laura Dion-Jones Show. We're on the air with Dr. Bob Tabale, Republican candidate for Kane County Coroner. And we have a lot of stuff to talk about. One of the things I want to talk to you about, and I'm going to be, when I get rolling, I tend to talk real fast, but I'm curious, what gave you the idea to run for Kane County Coroner since the Kane County Coroner race seems divided between a law enforcement candidate and a doctor, which is yourself? I totally disagree with your Republican opponent. The coroner's office may not be a medical position, but it sure helps if you're a doctor and understand what's going on medically. I personally think that you have the perfect skills for the job of Kane County Coroner, in my humble opinion. Tell us why you want to become Kane County's coroner.
Well, this race is very clearly defined between should the coroner be a law enforcement background person or a medical background person. And I initially ran for coroner 8 years ago when a patient of mine Mazda to get the office shipshape and back on track. The current coroner's under a 5-count felony indictment. He was indicted fully 2 years ago, and that keeps getting pushed down the road. There's been some problems with judges. One judge died, another judge.
Mysteriously.
He had cancer, sadly.
Oh, that is sad.
That was T. Jordan Gallagher, I understand. I don't know, never met him, but I heard he was a real nice man. In any case, he's on like the fourth. It doesn't like the fourth judge handling the case, so that's tying it up a bit. But in any case, the office has been beset with significant identity problems and morale problems, and so it'd be important for someone with experience to come in and get the office straightened around procedure-wise. And I have the ability to do that, and
sure,
because I have a lot of experience doing that. My opponent has no management experience.
The experience that I have, though, is being a talk show host, and you're listening to the Larry Dion-Jones Show. We're on the air with Dr. Bob Tavale, Republican candidate for Kane County Coroner. Speaking of policy and mismanagement, what do you think about the gross mismanagement and inky stuff going on down at the Cook County Morgue these days?
Well, a lot of things that are going on down at the Cook County Morgue are impacting in the Cook counties as well, but not nearly as many people are being affected. And that is, the economy hits everyone everywhere. The economy is hitting the morgue in that when people have loved ones who die, they can't afford to bury them. So they leave them at the morgue. They leave them at the morgue. And that has always been, there's always been 100 or so that they bury in a mass grave in the summer.
Seriously?
Yeah, but now there's like 300 that are unclaimed. But I know Kane, Steele, and Kendall, all the other counties have the same thing. But they only have one or two people who are being picked up. But it's always a problem. And when you have someone that dies, there was an article in the local paper, the Courier, I believe, about a person who died locally, and it was difficult to get his family involved, and you have to appoint a guardian for that deceased individual, and the judge and the guardian decide what to do. The guardian's usually with the coroner's office about disposing of the body, either cremating them or burying them or taking their assets and paying for the funeral and stuff. Those processes run exceedingly slow.
I'm sure they do.
So it would be great if legislators, I'd be happy to work up a bill and bring it to my local legislator and try to put it before the legislature about speeding that process up. Because right now it can take 4 to 6 months to get a guardian named, and then another 4 to 6 months to get the...
So meanwhile, the state's got to keep the body on ice, excuse me for being so, but
Well, the coroner's office, and they've got limited resources.
And you know who you should get in touch with? Maybe Illinois State Senator Carol Pankow, because she's my guest next week with Illinois State Senator John Milner. So if you remember, it's the day after the big,
day after the big day.
Yeah, kind of. So anyway, we'll talk about that later. It seems that everyone, though, is running around trying to find out who leaked the story to the media about the Chicago, the Cook County Morgue, instead of working to improve these horrendous conditions. Like you just mentioned, you would like to see things done, that you would help write the bill. I wouldn't want to work there at the Cook County one.
Well, it may not be a glamorous job, but it's a very interesting one. And there's one of the reasons why